And that if you mix Hell Sweep with 4-4-3, I can actually see the 4-4-3. So the way this works is that it sounds like this should be impossible because it's 19 frames, right? But the thing is, the way this animation works is that pretty much very early in the animation, Kazuya puts his left leg high up to give you a very clear indicator that now the 4-4-3 is coming.
Oh, you mean like this?
It stays there for a few frames, and then it comes down. So when you hear, you know, oh, 23 frames is where, you know, humans can react to stuff in Tekken, it's all about the animation. Because when you think about it, 20 frames is actually a third of a second, right? That's a bit of time, you know? So the reason this is reactable is because Kazuya, very early on in the animation, gets the leg up. So you can actually look for this.
Oh, so now, magically, suddenly, animation matters. When it's to advocate for Kazuya, the subtleties of the animation suddenly matter, right? Let's just keep going for now. We'll get back to this.
So people like Arslan, they're very good at catching 4-4-3. Kazuya's back immediately goes straight, and then the leg goes up, and then he waits, and then it comes down. You can sort of react to this mix-up, you know, if you have very fast reflexes, and if your opponent is obvious, but you're not gonna do it anyway in a real match most of the time, because the only way this works, at least for me, is if I stay crouching. I have to stay crouching to block the Hell Sweep, and then I can see 4-4-3, and I can stand guard. But you don't want to do that anyway, because any half-decent Kazuya player is going to mix you up with shit like this, shit like this, shit like this. I use 4-4-3 quite a bit. I actually don't use Demon Godfist that much in this game. I use this instead, because the Devil Fist tracks a lot, and it's minus 9 on block. Against really, truly great players, this is not a real 50-50 against truly great players.
To be completely honest with you, I do believe you. Not only I believe you, as I can also demonstrate why I believe you when it comes to this specifically. That is, perma-ducking and reacting to 19 frames FF3 animation. If we are doing it, if you can do this, and so can I, so it is possible. But here's the thing. By showing that the act of perma-ducking to react specifically to FF3 is not sustainable in a real match where Kazuya will FF2, instant while standing 2, FF4, F4, and so on, you just admitted that Kazuya's 50-50 is significantly stronger than Jin's 50-50, which you categorically denied previously. Even more now that Kazuya has a 16 frames Devil Fist, a Demon Ball, making it a perfect mix-up with the 16 frames Mishima Hell Sweep. You pretty much admit the only way to react to Kazuya mid option is by perma-ducking to react to the 19 frames mid, while at the same time, reaction to a 16 frames Hell Sweep is completely out of the question, of course. Meanwhile, when it comes to Jin's 50-50, you just have to hold back to block all his mids and specifically react to Gedan Mawashi Giri, a 20 frames textbook Kyokushin low kick. Once again, you just proved my point even further, that Kazuya's 50-50 is much, much, much stronger than Jin's 50-50.
So I'm not saying it's easy, I'm just saying it can be done.
And so did I. I never once said Jin's LRK, his Hell Sweep, is easily reactable. I never once said that. I said it is reactable, meaning reacting to it is within the realm of possibilities. meaning it is humanly possible. But you still took me for a liar and said that I was being disingenuous. It was logistically impossible to debate with you in your stream because I was typing through a smartphone. It was materially impossible to address your arguments point by point. You never once gave me the benefit of the doubt. You just took me for a dishonest liar to all your followers. And you have no idea the consequences it brought me. Even though I won't ever blame you for that. Because you're really not responsible for the actions of your followers. And I acknowledge that. But when it comes to Kazuya's 50-50, you're now claiming it is reactable. But let's recap what you had to say about Jin's 50-50. Mind you, 4 frames slower than Kazuya's 50-50.
One that was very difficult for me is when you say that Jin's hell sweep is reactable. I'm just like, it's not. It 100% is not reactable. So when that's your basis for saying Jin's 50-50 is 100 times worse than Kazuya's, I'm just like, come on, man. And yours is legit almost as strong. But in your video, you say Kazuya's 50-50 is 100 times stronger than Jin's. And I'm just like, are we playing the same game? I can actually record between 443 and this, and you'll block it 100%. Well, congrats. You can do what Nii can't do. And that if you mix Hell Sweep with 443, I can actually see the 443.
Well, congrats, Mayman. You're doing something that, according to your own previous logic, when it applied to Jin, Nii can do as well. And it gets even worse because your option is 1 frame faster. Or is it something else? Or is it because there might be something else involved here? It's almost like animations matter when it comes to reactability, right?
You claim that this is a reactable low. That low is not reactable, buddy. Do a test yourself. Blocking this on reaction.
Well, if living proof is not enough, if me consistently reacting to it is not proof enough, maybe the issue here is that for most people, what really matters is not what is said specifically, but rather who says it. Since I'm not a famous Tekken influencer, my words means jack shit, right? All the material proof I provide means jack shit, right? I can keep reacting to his 50-50 for 2 hours straight, but I'll still be disingenuous, I'll still be dishonest, I'll still be a liar, right? If my words are worth nothing, maybe I just have to appeal to someone else, right? Someone who happens to be more influential than I do. Maybe if I maintain the message, but change the messenger, people might start believing what is right in front of their eyes for a change.
React to the hell sweep. React to the hell sweep. Nobody's gonna believe me if you're a new player, but Jin players at the highest level are reacting to this hell sweep.
Do a test yourself. Blocking this on reaction.
Maybe not in tournament. You'll see it hit in tournament. That's nerves, that's jet lag, that's discomfort, that's a lot of things, monitors, everything. At the highest level, people are reacting to this. Why is this possible? Look at Jin's animation. Okay? The trick here for why this is reactable is to look at Jin's shoulders. This is the only animation where he turns his shoulders like that. When he does the mid, his shoulders stay square. When he does the hell sweep, he shifts. Down back four is arguably harder. You see, he also turns his shoulders. He stutters, and this is the only way he turns it. This is the only animation he has that does this. This is why it's possible. This is why it's possible. And the down two is arguably the easiest of all of these, but this is new to Tekken 8. I'll show you how to record it. You do a deep dash forward, forward three. You do a dash down forward four, 1-4. I'm just recording them all, and I'll show you in a sec. You do the mid extension. And this one's going to piss people off. You do dash hell sweep. You do dash down back four. And then you do dash Jin down two. I would actually just do the down two standing by itself. But yeah, let's get started. I probably have to stop talking to lock in to do this. If you can do this, you are warm for the day. You go beat up everybody, bro. Okay. And you can see my dashes are probably not the same. Okay. Yes. And this is what you will do. This is what the best players in the world, not maybe not literally this drill, but again, this is a speed kicks drill, right? So this is the stuff he came up with to increase his reaction speed.
Maybe I'm living in a parallel world where the subtleties of animations matter when we are taking into account the reactability of Tekken moves. But apparently, when it comes to Jin, neither animation nor frame startup matter. Because when it comes to Kazuya, the move main man claimed to be reactable, Kazuya FF3, is actually one frame faster than the fastest option in Jin's 50-50. Jin's 50-50 is overall 4 frames slower than Kazuya's 50-50. My X-Kick, my Kakato Otoshigeri, is 4 frames lower than your X-Kick. My Hell Sweep is 4 frames lower than your Hell Sweep. Here's what happens when I apply the same modus operandi I did with Jin to Kazuya's 50-50. Just as I did with Jin, I'll simply hold back to block all his mids, and I'll try to react to his lows.
Bear in mind that the only reason that didn't go so bad and my success rate wasn't completely ruined is the fact that the computer did not decide to go for Kazuya Hellsweep more frequently. Otherwise, I would be doomed. Let's see what happens if I program only FF3 and the Hellsweep. See? There's absolutely no hope. Nothing can be done. It is impossible.
Well, I guess that covers everything I had to say, and now I can feel vindicated for everything that happened. I thank you guys for watching, the people that keep asking me for more Tekken content. The people who keep asking me to produce more videos, even though I can't even play Tekken 8 yet. You guys are really the best. And if Mainman ever comes across this video, please, try to be mindful and more cautious with your words. Words are very powerful. You are a beacon for the Tekken community. You have no idea the weight they have and what they might cause to people who interact with you. Once again, I thank you guys for watching and we'll be seeing each other again. God bless.
You greatly exaggerate the movement aspect, Nova, which I think is a little bit disingenuous. Sorry. What you have found is a very specific situation where something weird happens. It's just something weird happens in this specific interaction. I mean, you're just looking at very niche stuff. I know you showed a very, very specific situation. Jin's movement is just like Kazuya's in pretty much any situation. Jin has pretty fucking decent movement. You see how quickly he moves here? Laterally? Jin has good movement. What you have found is a very specific situation where something weird happens with his left foot there. I mean, you're just looking at very niche stuff. If fixing is... Nova, you have movement like Kazuya with Jin. It's just something weird happens in this specific interaction. Jin's movement is fine, and Kazumi tracking him when he steps doesn't mean he has bad movement.
Oh no, I don't leave.
But I saw you with my own eyes.
Well, who are you gonna believe, me or your own eyes?